So our first speaker is going to be Mikhail Nekhludov. He's going to talk about ergodicity of infinite particle systems and applications. So.
Okay, thank you. First of all, I'd like to thank Slava for the invitation. Today, I'm going to talk about certain algebraic construction which first appeared in the study of long-time behavior of certain interacting particle system, and then found some applications for the theory of Lie algebras, and later for the theory of general topological algebras. So the plan is as follows. First, I will briefly discuss the interacting particle system and explain how the algebraic construction arises there. Then this construction is actually some kind of extension of classical Jordan-Schwinger map. So I will discuss application of the Jordan-Schwinger map for the Lie algebras. And afterwards, I will talk about some analogous construction, which I will call algebraic Jordan-Schwinger map, for topological algebras. And in the end, I will present certain open directions of research. So let us start with some brief introduction into the theory of interacting particle systems. So we have a space of configuration, which is usually R to the power of the d. In our case, it will be we have a lattice in our example. We have a set of atoms in the lattice. We will consider for simplicity just one-dimensional lattice. Each atom is characterized by just each momentum. Let us denote E, number of the atom. Then we have an energy function. In the example, we are going to consider energy of the atom E. It will be just xe square. And informally speaking, we assume that equilibrium is described by the family of measures which physicists usually call Gibbs measures. So they have, informally speaking, the following description. It's exponent of minus energy over temperature divided on some normalizing constant. And the evolution is described by some Markov semigroup with infinitesimal generator L. And the questions of interest for us will be rigorous proof that the measures are invariant, and ergodicity, that is convergence of the system when time converges to infinity to invariant measure, and the rate of the convergence. Right, now I'm going to talk about the particular system. The system is described by the following infinitesimal generator. So, as I said, we have a set of atoms on the lattice, and each neighboring atoms are exchanging energy between each other. Okay, so. And exchange organized in such a form that the locally energy is conserved. You can see that this operator, which describes exchange of energy between neighboring atoms, is such that it conserves total energy of the atoms. The operator xi differential with respect to xj minus xj differential with respect to xi. If you write down in the polar coordinates, it's just a derivative with respect to the angle between atoms ij. So it conserves the local energy xi square plus xj. J square, so we will denote it here in this picture as a circle. So this is the system which appears in the heat conduction models, and also it in a different form appears in the fluid mechanics and in theory of quantum spin chains. And so the first question, the problem mathematically, mathematical difficulty here lies in the fact that, as you can see, that all operators are equal zero at one point, when at the point zero. If xi is equal zero for all I, then we have that all generators are zero, so they degenerate at one point. And so the classical conditions, like Hermander condition, are not satisfied. And so we cannot use some standard methods to study ergodicity of such system. But what we also can see that we have a non-trivial Lie bracket between neighboring operators. We denote from now on xij, this operator of rotation. So the first task was to prove that the Gibbs measure, in this case it's a standard Gaussian product measure, is actually invariant measure. And so the idea actually already on that level, we use certain algebraic trick. In the sense that what we do, we represent our operator as a sum of two operators. Let me put here in blue. So what we do, actually, we represent our operator L as a sum of L1 plus L2, where L1 is a sum over even atoms with even number. So they describe, say, by the blue circles. Okay, let's be blue circles. And L2 is a sum over E even, let me write now. And here sum over E odd, X E, E plus one square, X E, E plus one square. And so what we can see that L1 is a sum, when we look, you could see that each operator acts only two neighboring atoms. So the circles in each sum, L1 and L2, they will not intersect, so they will be, the operators will be commuting. And because of that, for the semigroup P1T generated by the first operator, we have a, we immediately can get that invariant measure is a Gaussian product measure. For the semigroup generated by second operator, we also have the same thing. And then to prove that the invariant measure for the sum, what is our Gaussian product measure, what we do, we use Trotter formula, which basically the formula which states that this is a limit when n converges to infinity, exponent of t L1 over n, exponent of t over n L2, to the power n. And then using that Trotter formula, some variant, infinite dimensional variant of that formula, some particular variant, we can prove that we have here that Gaussian measures are invariant for the system and actually system is symmetric. So this is already on that level, we see that some algebraic considerations are useful. Now we are going to go to the ergodicity of the system, and here is the main lemma. We prove that norm of the derivative of the semigroup in the direction I converges polynomially to zero. And the rate of the convergence is optimal, as you can see from a simple example. If you take f like that, we will get immediately that the rate of convergence is exactly t to the power n minus n over 2. And to prove that lemma, we need a certain algebraic construction. The proof actually goes, the key part of the proof goes as follows. So we first we did some standard calculation here, and here appears commutator between derivative in the direction and infinitesimal generator. And then we use the following algebraic structures, derivative. Commutator between derivative and the rotation gives us sum of derivatives in two other directions. And then using that structure, we can, L is the sum of squares of this operator, so we can calculate the commutator. And after some technical cancellations, we will get that f of t, where f of t is norm of the derivative of the semigroup in the direction E. So F is a function of two variables, time and the number of the atom. Satisfies differential inequality. We here we have a Laplacian with respect to the on the lattice, so Laplacian with respect to the enumeration of the atoms. And then we have, by comparison theorem, the following inequality. And from here, knowing asymptotics of this semigroup, discrete Laplacian semigroup on the lattice, we immediately get the lemma. And then the question appeared, what is the structure? And where it appears from. Using that lemma, we can prove the ergodicity of the system. Also, and actually, what we use also, we use a commutation that our operator L, which I introduced before, it commutes with the standard Arnstein-Uhlenbeck operator. Using this fact, we could prove that the infinite sum here also converges to zero. And we have from Poincaré inequality. Also, this convergence rate is already not so optimal. We will get ergodicity of the system and polynomial rate of convergence to equilibrium. So now I'm going to talk about this structure. But first, we will need to define what is Jordan-Schwinger map. So what we have, okay, here is again, I have written the structure. So Jordan-Schwinger map was introduced by physicists. So what they did around 100, actually long time ago, 100 years ago, actually by Jordan himself, what he did, he had some classical Lie algebras and he wanted to represent them with operators in the Fock space. So he introduced the following map, which takes some matrix. And in the end, we get an operator. Here is AI, AJ joint are boson creation and annihilation operators. So in particular realization, actually, AI is operator of multiplication on the variable XI, and adjoint will be derivative in the direction XJ. So he introduced this map. And then it has two properties. First, it's algebraic homomorphism. And second, which is actually was not really used by physicists, that it's in this realization, it's a linear vector field. In the sense that it's a vector field with linear coefficients. So, okay, so we have that construction, and now we can extend it. So this is an extension for the infinite dimensional situation. As you can see, it's quite similar. So we take an operator A on some topological vector space. We assume that it has certain B-orthogonal system. We work in the framework of topological vector spaces instead of the framework of Hilbert space for the reason is that when we look at infinite dimensional Lie algebras, they're never Hilbert spaces. So we must consider more general situation. So existence of B-orthogonal system was shown that it exists for all locally convex separable topological vector spaces. So we define our Jordan-Schwinger map in this fashion. And then we have also certain extension, derivative in the direction and multiplication in the direction. So these operators satisfy the following, they form certain Lie algebra, they satisfy the following commutation relations. And you can see that the second line will be exactly our initial algebraic structure in the particular case when we consider anti-symmetric matrix EIG minus EJI, where EIG matrix unit. And derivative is derivative in the direction XE will be delta map in the direction EE. So the algebraic structure, the one which I introduced before, was a particular example of that general definition. And using these commutation relations, we can prove the following theorem, that if we have an arbitrary Lie algebra and we have a faithful representation, then taking composition. Okay, I have written minus D for the reason that actually here, as you can see, it's actually, for technical reason, it's an anti-homomorphism. But taking minus of it, it will become, or adjoint, it will become homomorphism. So this is. So taking composition of minus d with faithful representation or d adjoint with faithful representation, we get a representation of our Lie algebra with linear vector fields. And if we know that our algebra also topological locally convex separable, then we can we have an embedding. We can use in this case adjoint representation, and we have an embedding of factor algebra G over the center into the semi-direct product of linear vector fields. As an application of that theorem, we have the following construction of representation of Schrödinger-Virasoro-Lie algebra with linear vector fields. So Schrödinger-Virasoro-Lie algebra is by definition certain extension of Witt algebra. So what we do, we first take some realization of Witt algebra. Then we use Jordan-Schwinger map, and as soon as we used it, we have an extension with derivatives in the direction. So we choose certain set of direction, and then using derivatives in that set of the direction, we get a realization of the our Schrödinger-Virasoro-Lie algebra. And it seems that the result seems to be new. Okay, so this is how it works in the case of Lie algebra, and the natural question which appeared, if you can generalize that framework for general topological algebras. In that case, we would want, instead of conservation of Lie bracket, we would want to have conservation of the product. And it happens that it's actually possible. The idea is here is the following. As you can see, in our definition, we use I use here particular realization of creation annihilation operators for the simplicity, but in reality we could put here general boson creation and annihilation operators on Fock space, like in the beginning. And so the idea would be to exchange, instead of boson creation annihilation operators, use generators of Kunz algebra, so mutually orthogonal isometries on the Hilbert space. Let us go to the definition. So first we would need to define what is Kunz algebras. So here is a formal definition. So we have a set of generators, SE and SE adjoint. Here n is a parameter, could be natural number or infinity. And example of realization of this abstract definition is that we have a mutually orthogonal isometries on Hilbert space. In the case n equal to, I will give particular example. So we define first operator S1 on the orthonormal basis of our Hilbert space as S1 of EK is equal to E2K. And second, we define on the orthonormal basis as S2 of EK E2K plus 1. And extend by linearity to all elements of the Hilbert space, these two operators. And then you could easily see that they bear isometries, they conserve distance. But also because they take values in the orthogonal each other subspaces, they will be mutually orthogonal, and this properties will be satisfied. So this is when n equal to, and similarly you could construct for general n or for countable infinity. Okay, so this is a definition, and now we can we can define an algebraic analog of Jordan-Schwinger map. So we changed creation annihilation operators by generators of Kunz algebra. We have analog of derivative in the direction and the multiplication in the direction. And immediately we get the following commutation relations. That again will be anti-homomorphism. So to get homomorphism, you can just take a joint of there. And we have a structure of the model with the derivatives in the direction to the left and structure of the model to the right with multiplication in the direction. And in that lemma immediately has several applications. First, we have a invariance of the spectrum. Это our operator conserves the spectrum in very general situation. If we assume that we are in work with Fréchet spaces. And we can prove spectral generalization of spectral theorem here. So this is analytic application. What happens here is that our initial operator was defined on general locally convex topological vector space. But Kunz generators are operators, isometries on the Hilbert space. So when we applied our map, we have transferred our operator from some locally convex topological vector space to the operator on Hilbert space. And then we could just use standard spectral theorem in the Hilbert space. And using this commutation relation, this extension, we could go back. Because, for example, the second relation gives us, for example, that our representation is faithful, because it uniquely defines our initial operator. And using that, we have that commutator between, not commutator, product of derivative in the direction and product in the direction, we get a duality in our topological vector space. We could go back, basically, and get a spectral theorem for such an operator. Of course, we could analogically get representations of general locally convex separable topological algebras. So what we do, we take instead of a joint representation, like we did in the case of Lie algebras, we take just a operator of the product with fixed element A, and we take composition of the shift with our Jordan-Schwinger map, and we get a representation, and we have a structure extension to the structure of the module. And we have injectivity in this situation. And as an application of that, we can, in the case of a arbitrary finite dimensional algebra, we have a representation of its element with a transfer operators. For that, we use some particular representation of Kunz algebra ON. So this is, here we use a little bit of theory of wavelets. So we have some topological compact space, we have a Borel probability measure, and we have N to one map. Then we define certain set of functions which in a sense are orthonormal basis, but not really orthonormal basis. They are the normal basis with respect to this map R in this certain sense. And in with such a definition, we could define a representation of the Kunz generator of Kunz algebra SI as a composition of F with N to one map multiplied upon MI. And we could calculate also a joint explicitly, a joint generator. And then we could apply our formula and immediately get a representation of element I of our initial algebra with certain transfer operator of certain dynamical system. So we can realize this lemma should be compared that before we have representation of elements of Lie algebra with differential operators with linear coefficients. And here, by comparison, when we go to general algebra, general finite dimensional algebra, because this is this representation only when n is finite, so it, for that reason it's finite dimensional, we have a representation with transfer operators. That's one application. And the other application, which actually is the quantization. So we have certain, here I will look on the case of finite dimensional system, but it could be modulo some technical details, could be done also in infinite dimensional situation. So what we have a Poissonian, standard Poisson manifold with Poisson bracket. We have operators of taking Poisson bracket and multiplication, and we apply our Jordan-Schwinger map, algebraic one, to these operators, take composition, and then we take certain linear combination, and in the end we get a quantization in the sense that it conserves Lie bracket, it transfers Poisson bracket into the Lie bracket, from identity it will be identity, and we have a correct commutation relations between operators of PI, QI. So the properties here is similar to one of pre-quantization. And then basically we have a you can generalize this construction in the case when n is infinite, so infinite dimensional Heisenberg algebra using a framework of white noise calculus. Okay, so now I'm going to talk a little bit about unsolved problems. First unsolved problem is what happens in the case of Q bracket, so the bracket that AB minus QBA. So can we conserve such bracket? Some simple consideration shows that we can that homomorphism conserving such bracket is possible only in case when Q is equal to 0, 1, and minus 1. So the case Q equal 1 is just first Jordan-Schwinger map, conservation of standardly bracket. Q equals 0, conservation of the product is the second case, and the third case is actually open problem, Q, conservation of antiproduct, AB plus BA. This is an open problem, and the first guess that instead of boson creation and the annihilation operator take fermion creation annihilation operators doesn't work. It will lead to conservation of Lie bracket itself instead of commutator. So that's one problem. Then application to other infinite dimensional algebras, such as Youngians and vertex algebras. Some work is already going in that direction. And then a connection with the theory of dynamical systems. As I said, we have we got here representation of elements of arbitrary finite dimensional algebra with transfer operators. And the last but not least is Jordan-Schwinger map as a linearization tool. Because as you can see, the first Jordan-Schwinger map is a differential operator with linear coefficients, which means that its exponent, to calculate exponent, you need to solve linear equation. While initial operator could be differential operator with non-linear coefficients. So we have a conservation of algebraic structure on the one side, but on the other side, system has been linearized. And what kind of properties are conserved is not yet completely clear. So this is this all I would want to say. Thank you.
So are there any questions? Okay, so if there is no question, let's thank the speaker again.